गणेश भी आगलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स वील सी स्टीम प्रॉपर्टीज, सेकेंड पार्ट इन दैट मोलियर डायग्राम. लर्निंग आउटकम: एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू इवेल्युएट स्टीम प्रॉपर्टीज फ्रॉम मोलियर्स डायग्राम. नाउ इन प्रीवियस सेशंस वी हैव स्टडीड द टेम्परेचर एंट्रोपी डायग्राम. नाउ दिस इज द टेम्परेचर स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम डायग्राम. देयर इज अ चेंज इन द सैचुरेशन डोम शेप. नाउ हियर पॉइंट नंबर वन टू दिस प्रोसेस इज आइसोबारिक प्रोसेस. द पॉइंट वन एफ जी एस, वन एफ जी एस इज आइसोबारिक प्रोसेस. सो वॉटर इज इन द लिक्विड फेज. रिमेंबर द सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड कर लेफ्ट हैंड रीजन इज द लिक्विड रीजन. द एरिया बिलो इनसाइड दिस डोम शेप इज वेट रीजन एंड दिस अपर रीजन इज द सुपर हीटेड वेपर रीजन. सो वेन वी स्टार्ट हीटिंग द वॉटर फ्रॉम पॉइंट नंबर वन, इट इज अ सेंसिबल हीट, विल फॉलो द आइसोबारिक एज डिस्कस्ड प्रीवियसली. देन फ्रॉम एफ टू जी पॉइंट इज द लैटेंट हीट प्रोसेस. ओके, नाउ एट एज द प्रेशर इज टेकन एज वन बार, द सैचुरेशन टेम्परेचर इज 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस. द पॉइंट नंबर जी इज ऑन द सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड एंड पॉइंट नंबर एस इज इन द सुपर हीटेड फॉर्म. नाउ इफ वी ट्राई टू जॉइन ऑल द सैचुरेटेड पॉइंट्स देन वी विल बी गेटिंग द सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड कर्व. दिस इज द क्रिटिकल पॉइंट एंड दिस इज द सैचुरेटेड वेपर कर्व. नाउ यू कैन सी हियर द सैचुरेटेड, सॉरी द क्रिटिकल पॉइंट हैज़ द प्रॉपर्टीज फॉर वाटर. प्रेशर, क्रिटिकल प्रेशर इज 22.09 मेगा पास्कल. ओके, एट क्रिटिकल पॉइंट द लैटेंट हीट इज जीरो. रिमेंबर, ओके. नाउ आफ्टर दिस वील मूव टू द मोलियर्स चार्ट. मोलियर्स चार्ट और डायग्राम इज वेरी यूजफुल फॉर सॉल्विंग द न्यूमेरिकल्स फॉर स्टीम नोजल. ओके, सो नाउ वील सी द मोलियर्स डायग्राम. So, Mollier's diagram is plotted on specific enthalpy versus specific entropy chart. On x-axis there is a specific entropy, on y-axis there is specific enthalpy. The saturated curve is having such type of nature. The critical point is somewhere here. This is the critical point. Then this becomes saturated liquid curve and this is the saturated vapor curve. So the dryness fraction of the saturated vapor curve is 1 and saturated dryness fraction of saturated liquid is 0. Then I can show the such a dryness fraction curves having suppose 0.1 value and 0.95. So in between that there will be 0.2, 0.3 and so on. Okay, so this is the nature of dryness fraction lines. The isothermal lines, constant temperature lines, is having this nature. These are the isothermal lines. The temperature along these lines is constant. In the study of moist air, it is observed that isothermal lines and isenthalpic lines are almost coincide. They coincide each other. Okay, isothermal line and isenthalpic lines are coinciding. Now, the isobaric lines, the nature of isobaric lines on the Mollier's diagram are having such type of slope. These are the isobaric lines. Along these isobaric lines, the pressure remains constant. At the same time, there are specific volume curves are also present. So these are the specific volume lines. This is the nature of the specific volume lines. So this is all about the Mollier's diagram. Now what we'll do, we'll try to locate the points if we know any two inlet properties of the steam nozzle. So consider this is the Mollier's diagram, HS diagram, and now I will show only the saturated vapor curve. This is the saturated vapor curve. Suppose you know the temperature, inlet temperature to suppose the steam nozzle. Steam nozzle inlet properties are one, steam is flowing through the nozzle, and suppose the exit state is represented by point number 2. If I know the inlet temperature is 300 degrees Celsius, assumption is there, and pressure is suppose 20 bar. Inlet temperature T1, inlet pressure P1. As the nature of the isothermal lines are these, and consider this is 300 degrees Celsius and the pressure line is 20 bar, then the intersection point is point number 1. The flow through steam nozzle is isentropic. The flow through the steam is isentropic, and if the exit pressure is around 5 bar, assumption once again, then what I will be doing, this pressure line is a 20 bar pressure line, I will search the 5 bar pressure line, I will search the 5 bar pressure line, and I will draw the parallel line to the y-axis, parallel line to the y-axis, okay. So the intersection of this isentropic expansion to the isobaric line occurs at this state represented by 2. Now Mollier's chart is very useful. If you know the inlet any two properties and outlet one property, you could represent the process on the Mollier's diagram, and corresponding properties like suppose if I take the projection from point number 1, I will get the H1 enthalpy. If I will draw such type of line, I will get H2. Remember, this is the graphical method of solving the numericals on the steam nozzle. Similarly, the specific volume, I will get specific volume of steam at point number 2, okay, in this fashion. So this is the use of Mollier diagram. Now I will try to show the Mollier diagram which is given in the, so I have taken from the Moran. So this is the Mollier's diagram. As we have discussed, the it is enthalpy versus entropy. This is the saturation curve. This region will be the wet region, this is the superheated region, whereas this is the critical point. These are the dryness fraction curves, okay. These are the isothermal lines, these are the isobaric lines. So if suppose this is the inlet to the convergent nozzle, taking the vertical projection will be isentropic expansion, and you could locate point number 2, that is at exit of the steam. Here we'll see the references. For further study, you could refer the Fundamentals of Thermodynamics by Boranke and Sontag, and second book, Fundamentals of Engineering Thermodynamics by Moran Shapiro. Thank you.